Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Kai Winborn, and the question I would like to ask you all today is, how can STEM be the solution to everyday problems? Throughout my life, I've seen people who want to change. I've met people who want to lose weight. I've seen students who want good grades. I've met families who want better economic wealth. But none of these people are willing to put in the work to change this. If we are truly going to be the change we wish to see, then it starts with commitment. People want to live in a world where trash just isn't there. The minds of too many modern-day Americans work like this. Once we throw something away, it'll eventually just vanish. But we can't seem to wrap our minds around where it goes exactly. So we go about our lives living in ignorance and feeling a false sense of happiness in everything we've accomplished as a nation and showing off our nation's green thumb. But at the rate we're going, just creating more and more garbage and not recognizing it as a major calamity, reality is going to start to kick in pretty quick, and we're not going to like what we see. Today, I would like to have a conversation with you all to explain why consumerism is such a big problem and how it is affecting our environment and our ecosystem. One of my favorite movies is that Disney Pixar movie, WALL-E. The reason I like this movie is because it is a prime example of how the human race just gets rid of everything after they're done with it. In that movie, the entire planet was covered with trash, so the human solution was to just abandon it instead of figuring out a way to change this. This is not the way to live. And if they had just recognized this problem in the first place, they could have avoided the problem before it got out of hand. In this movie, the humans were, and in reality still are, too stubborn or scared to change. And in my opinion, sooner or later, that silly and ridiculous kids movie might not seem so ridiculous. My solution is going to be centered around the STEM process and how we can use it to create a brighter and more sustainable future. STEM can be the solution to everyday problems. And by the time I'm done with this talk, you'll know what I mean. But there are many people who want to see the world change, but do absolutely nothing to change it. My dad is always telling me and yelling at me, saying, take out the trash. And, you know, eventually I just give in and do it. And every time I think to myself, this really stinks. But somebody has to deal with it after me. Where does it go exactly? After a little research, I found out that a lot of the trash we throw away, it just ends up in a landfill. I also found out that 45% of the garbage we throw away ends up in the ocean. That adds up to over 8 billion tons a year. And who has to deal with this? Marine animals. They love and need the ocean. It's their home. It's kind of hard to live in if their living space is blocked up with chemicals and garbage. Our chemicals and garbage. Now, I'm gonna try to put this into perspective a little bit and appeal to you guys as well, human nature, I guess. Now, how many of you like coffee? Okay, now how many of you like Starbucks? Well, Starbucks sells roughly 4 billion cups a year, and 75% of the profits they make off of the cup that you buy is from the cup, not even the coffee. But just think about how much goes into that one cup. That's cardboard, plastic, and paper to make the cup. That's packaging to distribute the cup. And then there's the cup, where we just throw wherever we please. And remember, if it's not your litter, it just ends up in a hole in the ground, where it could take about 500 years to fully decay. There's no question about it. We've had and currently have a problem on our hands, and we need to find a way to fix this. We need to find a way to fix the fact that our garbage is ending up in these oceans. This is where the STEM process falls into place. Now, there are many of you who might already know what STEM means, but for those of you who don't, STEM is an acronym for science, technology, engineering, and math. Here at Amana Academy, almost every grade has their own STEM course or set of classes, and to push the students into leaning more to thinking more like an engineer. But STEM can be and is much more than that. And if we let it, it can be the solution to all of our world problems, and it can be the thing that unlocks our true potential. So how can STEM be the solution to my situation? Well, believe it or not, there isn't just one solution. There can be many solutions. After 3 weeks of research, I came up with a solution of my own, and I would like to share it with you all. This year, I'm the captain of my LEGO robotics team. In our quest to clean up the world, we have focused on dealing with plastic and eliminating that from our oceans. So what we did was we would take a normal product that was originally made out of plastic, and we would create it out of completely recyclable material. What we did was we melted down and mushed up paper and cardboard, mixed it with water and cornstarch, and made a Frisbee disc out of complete biodegradable materials and 0% plastic. That's just one solution to a large problem. I mean, as explained before, STEM can be the solution to simple problems. It can be as simple as not having something to stop the door from flying all the way open. So you tie a rope around the door, then to something sturdy to make a makeshift doorstop. Or it can be as complicated as using the entire engineering design process to create some sort of contraption that keeps flies as well as bugs out of the house while the front door is still open. Now that would be an invention. But whatever the case, STEM can lead to change. And STEM can change the world into the way it should be. So what are you doing to change the problems in your community and the world you live in? What are you doing to deal with the fact that our trash is affecting precious sea animals? And how are you using the STEM process to change this? Remember, if we are truly going to be the change we wish to see, then it starts with commitment. Albert Einstein once said, "The world is not dangerous because of those who do harm, but because of those who look at it without doing anything." I choose to do something. Thank you.